If Solomon Ash showed that people conform to group influences, and Stanley Milgram demonstrated that most people will simply do as they're told by an authority figure, Philip Zimbardo is a psychologist who tells us that even the environment can influence attitudes and behaviours in a pretty powerful way. A person is not an isolated being, and social psychology suggests that each individual is likely to think and act rather differently depending on the social setting in which they find themselves. Think of a prison guard. What does this person look like? How do they stand? What are they wearing? How do they walk? How do they talk? The chances are you've never met a prison guard. Even in America, which has the highest incarceration rate of any country, only 716 in 100,000 goes to prison. However, even if you haven't met a prison guard or even seen the inside of a prison cell, you probably have a fairly clear idea of what to expect. This is because of schema, prejudices, stereotypes, and social representations, all sociocognitive processes to help us make sense of the world. In 1972, Philip Zimbardo led a study which, in his words, reveals the power of social institutional forces to make good men engage in evil deeds. Set in a constructed prison environment in the basement of Stanford University, the hugely famous study is known as the Stanford Prison Experiment. Zimbardo selected 24 mentally healthy middle-class college students for the study and allocated them at random to be a prison guard or a prisoner. The guards were provided with uniforms and mirrored sunglasses, and the prisoners-to-be were sent home to await the start of the experiment. And it started with a bang. On a Sunday morning, the 12 prisoners were publicly arrested at their homes, taken to a real police station for processing, and then transferred to the mock prison in the university basement. You might expect that these students were content to swap the prison of the university library for that of the basement. But what happened next forced Zimbardo to call off the experiment within a week. Despite the fact that the guards were just a coin toss away from having been made a prisoner instead, they all assumed an authoritarian, abusive persona. No one instructed the guards on how to behave. They created this behavior without direct instruction. Guards prevented prisoners from eating, took away their bedding, forced them to remove their prison clothes, punished them with chores like cleaning the toilet with their bare hands. On the other side of the coin, prisoners were submitting to the will and instruction of the guards, even though they were fully aware that they had not committed a crime for which they would deserve punishment, and had the coin toss gone the other way, they would have been a guard rather than a prisoner. Just 36 hours into the experiment, Zimbardo had to extract one of the prisoners from the study because he had sunk into such a severe depression, with fits of rage and uncontrollable crying. A few days later, when other prisoners started to display similar symptoms, Zimbardo heeded the advice of his then-girlfriend and ended the experiment early. It had become too dangerous, but in the process had served to prove Zimbardo's hypothesis. Perfectly normal, neurotypical, mentally healthy people can perform heinous crimes when they are immersed in a total situation that legitimizes the attitudes and behaviors that would be unacceptable in another setting. Zimbardo explained that his findings show that any deed that any human being has ever done, however horrible, is possible for any of us to do under the right or wrong situational pressures. It's clear how this applies to the case of negative behaviors, such as war crimes, but it's important to remember that social context can equally be a force for good. If you've got an example, it'd be great to hear from you in the comments. And remember to subscribe to receive the next video.